Hello friends, welcome back to I Made Me Think exciting video series tutorial for REST API testing. So in this video we will see REST API testing automation framework. So this particular video is basically an extension of the couple of videos which I have uploaded earlier. So in my YouTube channel for REST API, for this particular playlist, REST API testing using Java programming and JVA. So these are the three videos, and there were some comments that the source code is not compiling and there was some discrepancy. So I have designed additional modules to the existing one, and I have come up with a small framework. So let's get started. So REST API testing automation framework. So when we say REST API testing framework using Java, so typically the mandatory thing what it should do is it should be able to raise HTTP request and it should be able to pass the HTTP response, but that should not be the only goal all the time. We can add certain additional modules so that it will add value to the framework. So basically, apart from raising requests, so making the header, setting different type of content type, accept type, cache settings, body making, so making query parameter, form parameter, or bean parameter, metrics parameter, and so on. Basically handling the JSON in this body and in the response when we get a response, so handling the status code, response header, and response body. So these are the mandatory parameters, these are the mandatory modules, or these are the mandatory features for a REST API testing framework. But apart from that, we can consider additional modules. So it should support Cucumber BDD kind of framework. It should support writing test cases using Cucumber BDD, which is the recent trend in the market to write test cases or to build up the framework. Server health check. So this is also a nice feature to have, so that before we start our tests, suite of tests, consider that if we check the server is available, server is up on which the application is hosted, maybe one or couple of servers, and our application is running properly, or maybe we can start the application using this automation on a test in a test environment. So it's better to have server health check as an additional module, so which will save our time for a longer run. Server log analysis, so for basically for white box testing, where we not only validate the API request and response, but we also check on the server side the server logs, the server log files we can validate. So basically it's for a Tomcat or Apache or any kind of server, there are some server log files which are maintained on the server side. For example, Catalina logs or some other messages logs. So basically we can track that for a typical server, from which IP address the requests are coming, how many users. So we can do some graph, or we can do some analysis in statistics. So a small module I have implemented to check the server side, that whatever request I'm raising, they are being getting logged in the server side at the same time. Test data input using Excel or using CSV or properties file. So for a complex framework, complex API testing framework, so consider that we not only test single API, but we test cascaded requests. So for any particular type of API, so the test data may not be coming from the earlier request, but it might has to be from any Excel or CSV or properties or any other format. So we should be able to have this support already implemented in the automation framework. Test result reporting, so this is also one of the good feature. So traditionally, by default, for Maven and Cucumber based framework, so we have some index.html file, and then there we see that the test scenario is pass or fail by looking at the color of the output. So we have some additional plugins available and in Maven, so which will have a kind of a enhanced reporting, which will show the reports based on different criteria and graphical formats. So basically it will show some pie chart and bar chart, so which is very nice to see, and which is which gives immediate and good confidence when we present it to the stakeholders. Test result reporting in Jira and HP ALM tools. So these kind of tools, they expose certain REST APIs. So we can, after the end of our test, the core test, we can gather the response. Basically, each and every test case pass or fail, and we can using this REST APIs which are exposed for these tools, we can call those APIs and update the results. So these are the additional features which will add value to the framework. Now let's the project which I'm going to use here for demo, this is available in GitHub repository and the link is in the comment section. So let's get started. So this is basically a Maven based project. So let's see what is a POM file here, pom.xml. And so the library which I'm using for API testing is the REST Assured JV libraries. Version is this, which is fairly the latest version. And this is the arrangement done for the runner file. And this is the additional plugin which I was talking about. So this plugin basically from net.masterthought Maven Cucumber reporting, which will give our reporting a little more enhanced way to report. So here we need to set the project name. Basically this will appear in that HTML report which it generates itself. So project name, output directory, and cucumber output. So basically what it does is whatever tests are being run from this runner file, once it is finished, this will take the control, and this will basically see that where is the result in the JSON file, and based on this JSON file it will make a nice report in a proper HTML graphs and other format. So we need to set some additional parameters, build number and some other parameters, and this particular report will be generated in this particular directory. We can change this, but as of now let's see that this is the directory, this is the folder in which the report will be generated. Now let's see the runner file. This is here. So this is the structure I'm using. These are the cucumber options I'm using. I am not using any tags, so but for your own purpose you can use any of the tags. And point to remember is we should mention this cucumber JSON. So this particular path, this JSON will be used in this reporting related plugin, and it will use this JSON and make a nice report. So now let's see the cucumber BDD. So here as in explained in the earlier three videos, so these are the couple of scenarios which I have considered. So three valid scenarios I am using for these tests, and two invalid scenarios I am using for demo. So I am running a local Tomcat and on which I have hosted an application that is called as user management. The explanation for the same application is available in the videos and in the comment section. So this basically it's an application, it's a REST API based web application I'm running, which has exposed some 13 APIs to the end user, and I'm just using, so basically creating user, updating, sign in, sign out, and basic activity. So here in background I am just setting some user parameters, kind of a precondition, and this is the basic URL from which we can get started, and here we need to just add the endpoints. So now let's see in the valid scenario one. So what I'm doing is I'm doing a get sign up parameters post sign up. So I'm creating an account here with this email ID and activating it, doing a sign in and doing a sign out. And then I'm doing a common activity which is at the end of every scenario. So I will explain about this later. So here this is basically a cascaded way of doing API testing. So I'm raising a couple of requests, API requests, one and the after. And so in valid scenario 2, I'm also doing a little complex scenario. Valid scenario 3 is also a little complex scenario. So let's see the step definition. So step definition is very straightforward. I have one handle here, and using which I'm just calling a single method in this step definition, and in the step implementation I have performed it in a detailed manner. So if you see feature file runner file, step definition, step implementation, and some general utilities for passing JSON and raising requests. So now let's see for in the step implementation, for a simple GET request, what are the things we need to do if we are using REST assured JWA libraries. So first we need to have this response defined, and then we need to do something called connection setup. So let us see what is a connection setup. So for post for GET request, so we need to set the content type and the accept type. So as I have explained, as it is necessary for any REST API request, that we need to set the content type and the accept type. So this is what I'm setting it here. So we need to do connection setting, and then just call the method get request for the same request specification. So this depends on what method we need to call. So I have supported four methods: get, put, post, delete. So these what are the different methods and what is their usage and what are the input output parameters, that is explained in the comment section. Basically it is all about what is the web application we are running. So the scope of this video is to know what is to understand the framework and additional features, and not basically what application is being used. So one last point is, so here we need to how to raise this request and how to pass the response. So we have a sequence. So raise the request, so basically first make the header in the initial stage, make the header. So for get request, there is except setting the setting up the connection, which is setting the content type and accept type. We normally in this framework I am not setting any additional parameters, for example cache settings and other settings, but we can set it here for a larger framework, and then call a particular method with this URL and handle the response code initially. Response code whatever is expected, if that is the one as actual, so that's fine, otherwise just assert, and then parse the response. So response also I am parsing it. For get request, I'm expecting a 200 code, and if it is true, then I'm just parsing the predefined response in a JSON and key value pair manner. Similarly, I have implementation for all these different types of methods, so get, post, put, delete, and so on and so. So additional thing about this is server log analysis. So we will see that at the end of every scenario, I'm calling one step. Each user action should be successful, and here I am doing the server log analysis. Apache log analysis I'm doing. Basically I have hosted this application locally on my local Tomcat and Windows combination. So this particular combination, what happens is the log file is generated, but it is generated little late. So at the end of every scenario I am doing the log analysis, and what I'm doing is so for example valid scenario 3, so I am just checking that whatever requests I am raising, for that request particular log file, in that particular log file, whether that request is being logged or not, that is what I am checking. But for a end-to-end or for a larger framework, we can do certain analysis by what time the request is logged and from which IP address request is coming, which user is raising the request from which browsers and or any mobile devices. So, and we can do certain statistics on that. So as of now, for log analysis, I've just implemented to get the logs and see logs are appearing or not. So I know the path where it generates the logs. So basically this is the path, and this is the file name with which the log file naming will start, and it will do the certain opening the file and do the log analysis. So HTML format of reporting. So we have seen the advanced custom reporting. So I've basically added a plugin in the POM file and we will see the output. Now let's run our code once and see what happens. So before that, if you see in this target folder, there are only two folders here, and once the code runs, basically it runs Maven clean test command, and once it is done, we will see some additional folders under the target folder, and there we will see the advanced reporting. So if you see this Apache log analysis, so this is what after every scenario. At the end of every scenario, I am just running this particular step which will do the log analysis for me, and since the logs are getting generated a little late, so it will wait for the log file to get updated and then do the log analysis. So on a, let's say on a Linux server, non-Windows server, it might take very less time. So I'm running the six scenarios. So for six scenarios, it will do a lot of log analysis. So these are the prints are from this invalid scenario 1 and 2. Now if you see this log analysis, it's a simple example. So if you see, it has logged these particular requests. I think this is for the last invalid scenario. So get post get delete. So this is how the logs are generated in the log file. So I'm just parsing it here, and I can do further analysis, basically timing and from which IP address and some other stuff. So if you see, it has also logged what response the server has given to the application, to the end user. So everywhere mostly it's a success response, except this 406, because this is an invalid scenario test. So 415 and 416 it has given. Now if you see in at the end, so once our cucumber Maven tests are done, so at the end it is generating this cucumber reporting. So this is what this advanced cucumber reporting Maven plugin performs its job. And now let's just refresh the target folder, and you see this site folder is added and cucumber folder is added. So traditionally, if you see this index.html, the earlier or the normal reporting in which we will see that if the scenario is pass or fail, and it is just showing in a very simple manner. Now let's see this additional. By the way, this is where the cucumber.json file will be generated, and this will be taken as input to generate the advanced reporting. So if you see feature overview.html, and so now if you see, it is the reporting is very nice and it is very attractive, and it gives immediate information of what is happening, where the how the tests are done, where what is the percentage and stuff like that. It has a couple of graphs, so scenario, so it will give a tabular structure here. So let me just open this first in a normal browser. Now if you see this kind of an animation, and these are the additional features, additional enhanced reporting it has generated. So, and there are a couple of graphs here which will give immediate confidence. If you see here, feature tags, so in this case I haven't used any tags, but tag for particular tag, how many test cases are passed or fail or blocked or rejected, all those graph it will be a very nice graph. And steps statistics, so whatever number of steps were executed, so their duration, occurrences, average, and so this is a very, very enhanced and advanced reporting we can use so that it will give immediate confidence to the stakeholders. So that's all for this video, guys. So if you have any comments, please put it in the comment section and I will try to answer those. And for more exciting videos, please like, comment and share my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.